So students, today we are going to see general science of standard 7. So students, we are learning the lesson the living world adaptations and classification. So today we are going to see adaptation for ingestion of food in plants, and other is adaptations in animals. So see here, what is given here? Adaptation for ingestion of food in plant. So most of the plants are anchored in the ground and are autotrophic. However, plants like dodder, cuscuta are parasitic. The plant body of dodder consists of yellow wire-like stem. So see here, you can see the yellow wire-like stems. It is leafless and cannot perform photosynthesis. It has not got leaf. Okay. However, it has haustrial sucking roots for absorbing nutrients from host plant. They grow on other plants, okay, and they take out food from that plant with the help of yellow strings like stem, wire like stems. Okay, so these roots penetrate up to the conducting vessels of the host plant to absorb water and food. So like cuscuta plant or dodder, they live on other plant. They are parasitic and they absorb food with the help of wire like stems, yellow colored. They absorb water and food. Fungi do not have chlorophyll and cannot perform photosynthesis. They obtain food from starchy foodstuffs like bhakri and bread. They have root-like fibers for absorption of food. So also fungi, they are not autotrophic, okay, because of they can't produce their food. They live on other plants like fungi and cuscuta or dodder. So fungi sucks, they live on foodstuffs like bhakri and bread. So see here, next is plants need nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium for growth. So what are the main constant to grow? Nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium for growth. Okay, plants that grow in soil which is deficient in nitrogen like Drosera, Sendu, okay, the Venus flytrap, peacher plant, etc. fulfill their need for nitrogen by consuming insects. Adaptations are seen in these plants which serve to attract insects and hold them captive. So as plants require nitrogen for their growth, they take it from the insects body. So which are the plants? They eat insects, okay. So like Drosera, Sendu, Venus flytrap, peacher plant fulfill their needs nitrogen by consuming insects. So what is the adaptation? They attract with jelly, okay, to the insects and they kill them. So Venus flytrap, this is the photo of one plant. So see that. So on internet, on Google, you can search this website and you'll get different plants photo and their adaptations. Okay, it is will get on this website. So next topic is adaptation in animals. However, we have seen is the adaptation in plants, now adaptations in animals. Okay, so let us start. Make a list of animals in surroundings. Compare the diversity of animal listed by your friends with your list. Discuss the habitats, food habits, characteristics of body structure like vertebral column, wings, gills, tail, etc. and prepare a chart. So you have to do this activity at home. So what difference do you see between terrestrial and aquatic animals? Terrestrial means those are living on the land, and aquatic means those are on the in the water. Okay, so see here, as compared to terrestrial animals, the skin and body shape of aquatic animals appear to have undergone changes. Fishes have scales on the skin and fins on the body. Their body tapers towards both its ends like a spindle. Fish breathe with gills instead of a nose. Their eyes have transparent eyelids. They have air bladders within the body to help them to float. So these are the adaptation in the aquatic animals. For example, in the fish, what are they? So their skin and body has gills. Okay, so scales on the skin and fins on the body. So here are the fins and here are the scales on the body. Okay, now their body taper stores both the end. Taper means nimurti. In Marathi we can see this corner to this corner. This is a tapering. Okay, now they don't have nose. They don't breathe with the help of nose. They breathe with the help of gills. Okay, on their body skin. Now see here, these are the gills at the corner of the mouth. Okay, so they have transparent eyelid. Their eyelid are transparent. Okay, and they have air bladders inside their body, that way they can swim or float on in the water. These are the adaptation. So observe the bodies of frog, duck and tortoise. Of what use are their legs to these animals? What helps frogs to breathe underwater? Of what use are the long hind legs of a frog? Why their backside legs are longer than the front legs? So why doesn't a duck get wet in water? Why the down part of the duck not getting wet? What are the reasons? So let us see. We'll get here in the next paragraph. So see here. As the frog and duck have webbed toes, they can use their legs like oars. Water flows off the waxy feathers of birds like duck and water hen. So their feathers are waxy. Okay, their webbed too. Their toes are webbed. Okay, so they can use to swim in water. Okay. Webbed toes, slippery, smooth skin and a triangular head help frogs to swim easily through water. For what are the adaptation for frog? Webbed toes, slippery, smooth skin and triangular head. These are the adaptation for frog. They can live on land as well as in water due to their ability to breathe through the skin in water and using the nose on and lungs on the land. So the frog is breathe with the skin in water and with the nose and lungs on the land. So they amphibious, they live on water and land also. So the typical color of frog's back help it hide among the grasses. So because of the color of the backside of the frog is green, they can hide in the grasses also. Okay, make a list of names of some other amphibians you know and study their adaptation. So you have to make a list. Those are can live in water also and the ground also, like duck, like frog. You require to find more. Okay, now adaptations in forest and grassland animal. So see here, what are the adaptations in forest and grassland animals? So carnivorous animals like the wild dog, fox, tiger and lion. Carnivorous means those don't eat plants for food, they eat other animals, that is carnivorous. Okay, so have strong legs to run fast and capture their prey. They can run very fast and they can capture their prey. They have strong legs. They have claws and their canine teeth are sharp and pointed. What is the function of such teeth? The tigers have padded paws. This enables them to silently walk silently stack their prey and capture it easily. The eyes of predatory carnivores are located in front of their heads. It helps them to spot their prey from a long distance. So their both eyes are in the front. They have the canine tooth very strong. Okay, canine teeth are very strong. They have claws. Okay, and their legs are very strong, and they have padded paws. There, okay. So they can silently walk. They will not voice up legs. Okay. So these are the adaptations in carnivorous animals. Now, the herbivorous. Those are on the grass. They live on the plants. So what are they? The eyes of herbivorous are below the forehead. So their eyes are below the forehead, on either side of the head. Their eyes are both the side of the head. Like carnivores, their eyes both are in front of their face. Okay. This gives them wide angle vision either side of the head. This gives them wide angle vision, which helps to protect them from predators. Their legs are long and tapering with strong hooves, which enables them to run fast, taking long leaps. So if you see the part, last part of their legs is very strong. It is not like fleshy. Okay, it is with the strong bones like structure. Okay, so they can hoops, long jumps they can take, okay? The leaps. Okay, their legs are long, and tapering with strong hooves. Their hooves means last part of the leg. They are called hooves. They are strong, so they can take long leaps. Okay, their long and freely moving ears can receive sound from long distances and different directions. Their ears are very long and they are moving continuously here and there, and they get the voices, sounds from different directions at a time. Deer and blackbucks have colors that merge with their surroundings. The deer and blackbuck's color is like a soil or the surrounding where they are living in that environment. Their teeth are strong for chewing tough plant material. Their teeth are very strong. They can chew tough plant material also. Okay, these are the adaptation between the forest and grassland animals, carnivorous and herbivorous. So do you got it? These are the two pictures. This is a lion and this is a black buck. Number 5, this next is adaptation in desert animals. What are the adaptation acquired by the animals those are living in the desert? So see here, deserts are characterized by severe scarcity of water. There is very less water. Hence, desert animals have a thick skin to prevent loss of water from the body. So their skin is very thick. Okay, so loss of water is very less. Their legs are long with flat and cushioned soles. Their legs are very long. Okay, I have seen camels. So their legs are legs are very long and fleshy. Okay, cushion soles are there. The nostrils are protected by folds of skin. Their nostrils, the nose nostrils are with a protected fold of skin. The eyelashes are long and thick. Their eyelashes, those are there around their eyes, are very thick and long. Rat, snakes, spiders, lizards in deserts live in deep burrows during daytime and are active in night. So rats, snakes, spiders and lizard, they in desert, they live in deep they made holes, that is called burrows, and the daytime they be in that holes, and they after night they come out and start praying. Okay, so these are the adaptations. So adaptations in animals of snowy regions where snowfall is there. Okay, so what are the adaptations? So from the internet, download images of animal like yak, polar bear, व्हाइट फॉक्स, सिल्वर फॉक्स, माउंटेन गोट, साइबेरियन हस्की डॉग एंड स्नो लेपर्ड. कंपेयर दिस इमेजेस विद दोज ऑफ सिमिलर एनिमल्स फ्रॉम ट्रॉपिकल फॉरेस्ट. व्हाइट और सिल्वर बॉडी कलर, लॉन्ग थिक हेयर ऑन द स्किन आर टिपिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एनिमल ऑफ स्नोवी रीजन. वॉट आर द एडप्टेशन? सिल्वर बॉडी कलर, व्हाइट और सिल्वर बॉडी कलर, थिक हेयर्स एंड द स्किन, थिक हेयर्स ऑन द स्किन, दीज आर द टिपिकल एडप्टेशंस. सो एडप्टेशंस इन एरियल एनिमल्स. वॉट इज द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन व्हीकल ऑन द रोड एंड एरोप्लेन्स? The spindle-shaped body of bird also minimizes the resistance of air while flying. Spindle shape means this and this are very small, and in middle part there is a big size. Okay, this is called spindle shape. Okay, so that gives a very less resistance of air while flying. With hollow bones, a body covering a feather, and modification of four legs into wings. So what is the modification? Four legs into wings, and their bones are hollow and feathers on their body. Their body is light in weight and adapted for flying. So their body is getting very light in weight and adapted for flying. The body of insects also is light in weight and tapers at both ends. They can fly with two pairs of wings and also walk with six stick-like legs. Bats can fly with the help of patagium, a thin fold of skin between their forelegs and hind legs. Observe the various birds and insects in your area. So there are some insects, some birds, and bats are flying. So there are some modifications of body whichever we have discussed here, and they have got claws for holding on the plants. Branches, strong claws. See, so see here. Now, what are the next point? Are is adaptations in reptiles on page number 6. So, what are the adaptations? Observe from a distance how snakes and earthworms creep. Which organs do they use for creeping? Are there any special changes for that purpose? Note any such changes in animals like house lizard, garden lizard, crocodile use their muscles for creeping. Similarly, they show adaptations in skin, soles of feet, body color, etc. For example, the house lizard and monitor lizard have clawed toes and thin soles, whereas snakes have scaly skin. So these are the adaptations in the reptiles. Those are moving on the ground. They are moving with the help of their strong muscles of the legs, and they are creeping. Okay, their skin of snakes have got scales, whereas house lizard and monitor lizard have clawed toes. See these toes. And their skin, thick soles. Okay, now these are the adaptations in reptiles. Okay, their body color is matches with the surrounding. Now adaptations for food. What are the adaptation in different animals for food? Now here figures are given for woodpecker. There is a snake also. There are many other animals are there. Okay, so what are the adaptations are there? So let us see. We can categorize animal as herbivores and carnivores. Special adaptations are seen in each category to make the process of feeding easy. We will discuss this in greater detail in the chapter of nutrition. There is one chapter going to come afterwards. In nutrition, we are going to discuss this detail. So watch the programs on channel like National Geographic, Wild, Discovery, etc. to learn about the feeding habits of animals and like frogs, snakes, birds, mosquitoes, butterflies. okay, these are the adaptation. What are the adaptation? Okay, for feeding habits. So here you have to see there are TV channels, okay, National Geographic World and Discovery. So what are the, we have to discuss herbivorous and carnivorous. So we have to complete this chart. Okay, here given, for example, complete the following chart with your observation. Shark teeth. So which are animal there given? Lion and tiger. What is the adaptation? To tear the flesh. So here other are there. Long and pointed beak, short beak, long and sticky tongue, long neck. So who has got long neck? And for what is the purpose? You have to see. Okay, like long neck is for giraffe. For what? To get the leaves of bigger trees. Okay, for food. So these are all you have to see and you have to make a chart. Okay, you have to write in the notebook and you have to photograph and put in the group.